Hello everyone, good evening. So this is Sameer Sardana and today we will be discussing the arithmetic without formulas, mixture and solution part. I will be taking the 24th session today and tomorrow we will start with our next topic, that is ratio and proportion. So ratio and proportion will be started tomorrow and today we will complete the concepts related to mixture and solution. So guys, my name is Sameer Sardana and today topic is mixture and solution. This is my Unacademy profile address where you can access 750 plus video lessons for CAT exam on Unacademy learning app. So you can download the Unacademy learning app, visit to my profile and 750 plus video lessons are recorded for your CAT exam preparation on logical reasoning, data interpretation and quantitative aptitude. This is about Unacademy Plus. You can prepare for CAT exam on Unacademy Plus where 30 plus hours of live sessions are conducted, are being conducted every day. Good evening Shrey, how are you? And there are structured courses in English, 8 plus top educators are taking these courses and there will be new courses published every month. And next is a detail of the subscription fee for 1 month and for 6 months and 12 months. So if you go for 6 months or 12 months, your per month cost will get reduced, right? And using my code, referral code, that is sameersardana.ubs5752, you can have a 10% discount on the subscription fee. So I'm teaching live on Unacademy Plus for your CAT exam preparation, right? So guys, let's start with our concepts of mixture and solution. Now, I will be covering those questions today where the concept of removal and replacement of the solution is used, right? When you take a part of a solution and remove it with other solution, how the concept of successive percentage is used in such type of question, and we will be discussing that concept today. So I will be explaining you the concept, the basic concept with the help of this question. It is given that if 20% of the solution is removed and replaced with water thrice from a 80% alcoholic solution. Now there is an 80% alcoholic solution. Out of this 80% alcoholic solution, you are removing 20% of the solution and replacing it with water. And you are supposed to tell what is the percentage of alcohol left in the solution. Can you give me the answer of this question? If 80% of the solution is removed and replaced with water thrice from an 80% alcoholic solution, what is the percentage of alcohol left in the solution? So let me explain you the concept here. Let's talk about the concept, and the concept that I'm explaining now will be used in this complete chapter of mixture and solution. We'll be covering all these type of questions. Listen to this concept carefully, right? Let's discuss this concept. It's a very, very important concept. Let's understand the basic concept first and then we will solve other advanced level questions. See, the solution is 80% alcoholic, right? Assuming that the total content of the solution is 100 liter, right? This is just to make you understand the concept, right? Just listen it carefully, right? Once you understand this concept, you can solve all these questions without formulas, right? Without complex equation, you can solve this all. You can solve all questions of mixture and solution. Now, when I say that there's an 80% alcoholic solution, that means if the total solution are taken to be 100 liter, right? Out of it, 80% is alcohol. Right, 80% of alcohol means the 80 liter part would be alcohol and the remaining 20 liter would be water. So now let's say this is a container, right, which contains this 80 liter of alcoholic solution and 20 liter of water solution, right? This is 20 liter water. Okay, so now from this solution you are removing 20%, right? So 20% of this solution has been taken out. So when you do this activity, that means when you remove 20% of this solution, that means from the, you will remove the 20 liter part of it. That means this part of the solution will now be removed. Let's say this part of the solution is now removed and you are left with this part now, right? Now when you remove 20 liter of the solution, you can see that out of the 20 liter that you're removing, there's an 80% alcohol, right? Out of the 20 liter that you're removing, there is 80% alcohol. That means out of 20 liter, there would be 16 liter of alcohol. So 16 liter of alcohol from the top layer will be removed, and 16 liter alcohol will be removed, and 20 liter water from the top layer, and 4 liter water will be removed. So out of the 20 liter that you are removing, there would be 16 liter alcohol and there would be a 4 liter water. Clear? Now, once you remove 60 liter alcohol and 4 liter water, the total alcohol content left in the solution will now be 64 liter. Why 64 liter? Because initially you started with 80. Yeah, you started with the 80 liter of alcohol, right? And you removed. So you started with 80 liter of alcohol and you removed 16 liter. So you are left with now a 64 liter of alcohol. So now this is 64 liter, right? This part is 64 liter alcohol, and also 4 liter of the water is removed. So that means 16 liter water is now left. Now when you replace it with 20 liter of pure water, now when you add 20 liter of water solution to this part, you can see the alcohol will remain as it is. That means it will be 64 liter, but water percentage, the water value of water will get increased by 20. That means now the total solution will be 100 liter, but the water will be 16 liter. So right, so now 64% is alcohol, 64% is alcohol, and 36 liter is water. Now please understand this concept. When you remove 20% of the total solution and replace it with a 20% with 20 liter of the water, what is happening with the percentage of alcohol? What is happening with the percentage of alcohol? Look at it carefully. The alcohol percentage, or you can say the alcohol content, is getting reduced by 20 liter. Is getting reduced by 20%, right? Initially you have 80 liter of alcohol, right, in the initial solution. And now with the 20% removal and replacement, you have this alcohol content as 64 liter, or you can say 64%. So 80 liter of alcoholic solution has now get reduced by 20%. Now get reduced by 20% means the alcohol left in the solution is now 64 liter. Is it clear to all of you? How to decrease a value by 20%? This is a concept of percentage, right? And this complete topic is also dependent on the concept of percentage, right? So when you remove a part of the solution and replace it with some other solution, the alcohol is getting reduced by 20%. Now two important concepts that you need to concentrate on, that when you remove a part of a solution, which quantity will get reduced, and if it is getting reduced, by how much percentage it will get reduced. Now, because you are replacing the 20 liter of the solution with the 20% of the solution with the 20 liter of the water, that means the other content, other than content which is other than water, which is alcohol in this case, right? So alcohol will get reduced. First of all, this is the first question that you should ask to yourself, that if you are removing 20% of the solution and removing it, replacing it with some other content, which content will get reduced? In this case, alcohol will get reduced. And the next question is, by what percentage it will get reduced? The percentage will depend on the total percentage of the total solution that you are removing. If you are removing 20% of the solution and replacing it with 20% new content, that means alcohol will get reduced by 20%, right? Alcohol will get reduced by 20%. Now let's take the second operation. Now this was the first, this was the operation when you're doing it for the first time, right? This is for the first time, when you're removing first time 20 liter of it and replacing it with 20 liter of water. Now if you're doing this operation for the second time, right? If you're doing this operation for the second time, now you know that in the total 100 liter of the solution, we have 64 liter of alcohol and I have 36 liter of the water, right? Now if I again remove 20 liter of the solution, right, 20 liter, that means let's say the first layer of 20 liter is removed. Now in this 20 liter, you can see that you are removing 64% is alcohol. So out of 20 liter, 64% is alcohol. How much it is 12.8. so out of 20 liter, now 12.8 liter of alcohol will be removed and the remaining would be 7.2 water, right? And when you replace it with 20 liter of water again, this would be the now 64 minus 12.2 would be 51.2. So now alcohol would be 51.2 liter, and the water would be 7.2 plus 20 plus the pending, that is 28.8. Now it would be 48.8, right? So if 51.2 liter is alcohol, 48.8 would be the water now. Now look here again, observe it carefully, that you started with a 64 liter of alcohol, and when you remove 20% of the solution and replace it with water, now the alcohol content that is left is 51.2 liter, right? That means it is getting again reduced by 20%. So 64 minus 64% of 20. Or you can say 64 minus 20% of 64. Now when 20% of 64 is subtracted from 100% of 64, you will be left with the 80% of 64. Now when you take 80% of 64, that means you are reducing it by 20%, right? That means again here alcohol content is getting reduced by 20%, right? You started with 64 liter of alcohol and you are left with a 51.2% of alcohol. That means alcohol percentage is again getting reduced by 20%, and the leftover part is 80% of 64.2, which is 51.2, right? So again, alcohol is getting reduced by 20%, but this time this percentage decrement of 20% is applied on a value of 64. And this is a case of successive percentage decrement, right? So again, when you do this operation for the third time, now in the solution, you have 51.2 liter of alcohol and the water is 48.8. When I again remove 20% of it, that means if I remove 20% of solution, out of that 21, 51.2% would be alcohol, right? So the now alcohol left would be 51.2 minus 20 into 51/2 by 100, or you can say 51.2 minus 20% of 51.2. When you subtract 20% of 51.2 from 51.2, you will be left with 80% of 51.2. That means again, alcohol percentage, the leftover alcohol percentage is 80% of 51.2. That means alcohol percentage again get reduced by 20%. So this complete chapter is dependent on two concepts, that which content will get reduced and by how much percentage it will get reduced. And this will get reduced successively, right? So in this case, alcohol will get reduced, and by how much percentage it will get reduced? 20%. Why 20%? Because the total, you are removing 20% of the total solution and replacing with some other content, right? So this is a case of successive decrement, and you can straight away give you the answer by using the successive percentage decrement. In this case, that I have initially 18% of the alcohol in the first operation, 20% when I do the operation for the first time, I will be left with 80% of alcohol. And this would be the remaining part now. And when I do the operation for the second time, again, I will be left with 80% of this part. And when I do it for the third time, I will be left with the 80% of this part. And solving it, you will directly get your answer as 40.96%. So alcohol left in the solution would be 40.96%. Okay. So always answer two questions once you start solving it. That which content will get reduced successively and by how much percentage it will get reduced successively, right? Or this could also be asked in fraction also, right? So in this case, alcohol is getting reduced successively, and by how much percentage it is getting reduced? 20%. Why 20%? Because you are removing 20% of the total solution, okay? So these two questions will help you to understand that which content will get reduced and which and how will it get reduced? It will get reduced successively. If you are removing a part of a solution and replacing it with some other content, then the content that you are not replacing will get reduced successively by the same percentage as of the percentage that you are removing of the total solution. Okay, so now let's move on to the next question. This question says, if 10% of the solution is removed and replaced with milk four times from a solution which contains 50% milk. So you are removing a 10% of the solution and replacing it with milk this time. Now, what will be the percentage of the milk in the final solution? Can you give me the answer of this question? 10% of the solution is removed and replaced with milk four times from a solution which contains 50% milk. What is the percentage of milk in the final solution now? So answer two questions. First is, which content will get reduced? Now in this case, there are two content. One is milk, and the other content that you can assume is, let's say, water. Now, which content will get reduced? If you're replacing it with a pure milk, then the water percentage will get reduced. And if the water percentage will get reduced, by how much percentage it will get reduced? It will get reduced by 10%. Why 10%? Because you are removing 10% of the total solution. Okay. The moment you get to know that there would be 10% successive decrement in the water percentage, you can solve this question in one single line using the concept of successive percentage decrement. So now give me the answer to this question. What will be the answer? The question is asking what is the percentage of milk in the final solution, not the percentage of water. This is the percentage. See, 50 initially the solution contains 50% milk, right? So therefore, if you are replacing it with water, the milk percentage will go up. The answer cannot be less than 50. Milk percentage is initially 50%. After you are once you are removing it, it will get increased, right? Yes, water, you are supposed to tell the percentage of milk in the final solution. So what is the initial water percentage that you have? If the solution is 50% milk, right? If the solution is 50% milk, that means there would be 50% water. Now, I know that by doing this operation, by replacing it with the pure milk, my water percentage will get reduced. By what percentage it will get reduced? It will get reduced by 10% successively. Each time it will get reduced by 10% successively. So first time it will get reduced by 10%. That means you will be left with 90% of the solution. Second time again, you will be left with 90% of the solution. Third time again, you will be left with 90% of the solution. And fourth time again, it will get reduced by 10%. That means you will be left with 90%. So finally, the water percentage, once you solve it, is 32.80%. Right? This is 32.80. So out of 100% at present, if the water percentage is 32.80, the percentage of milk will be 67.2%. Is it clear to all of you? Just use the case of successive decrement. You're supposed to answer two questions. That which content will get reduced successively and by how much percent it will get reduced successively, right? The percentage will depend how much of the total solution you are removing and which content will get reduced. That will depend which content you are replacing. If you are replacing it with the milk, that means water will get reduced. If in this question we would have been replacing it with water, then the milk would have been got reduced, right? So initially you have 50% of the water. So after doing it for the first time, you will be left with 90% of it. For the second time, again, you will be left with the 90%. Then again, reduce it successively by 10%. So do it for the four times and you will see the water percentage now left is 32.8. If water percentage left now is 32.8, that means out of total 100%, if 32.8 now is a water, that means milk percentage would have been 67.1. Initially, it was 50% milk solution. Now, because you are replacing it with milk, the milk left will now be 67.2%. Okay, so it is getting increased by 17.2%. Is it clear to all of you? The water percentage, milk percentage is getting increased. Okay, just take this concept in a simple way. Just try to answer two questions: which content will get reduced successively, and by how much percentage it will get reduced successively. The moment you get to know about these two concepts, all these questions of removal and replacement of mixture and solution can be solved with the concept of successive percentage decrement. Is it clear to all of you? Can we move ahead? So let's try the next question. Can you give me the answer to this question? Question number 3. From a milk container, 6.67% is removed and replaced with water. Next, 14.28% is removed and replaced with water. Again, 8.33% is removed and replaced with water. What is the percentage of milk in the solution now? Now, answer two questions. Which content will get reduced? Here, you are replacing with water. That means you are removing a part of the solution and replacing it with water. That means water percentage will go up. If water percentage will go up, which content will get reduced? It will be the milk content. It will be the percentage of milk that will get reduced, right? And by how much percentage it will get reduced, that depend how much of the total solution you are removing and replacing. So now give me the answer of this question. For in the first operation, you are removing 6.67%. In the second operation, you are removing 14.28%. In the third operation, you are removing 8.33%. You are supposed to tell the percentage of milk in the solution. Can you give me the answer? Just reduce the milk percentage successively and you will get the answer in one single line. When you remove 6.67%, right? What is the percentage of the milk initially? See, you are removing 6.67% initially for the first time from a milk container. That means you will assume initially you have 100% pure milk, right? You have 100% pure milk. Now when I remove 6.67% and replace it with the water, the milk percentage will get reduced by 6.67%. What is 6.67%? 6.67% is 1 by 15. So that means it will get reduced by 1 by 15. If it will get reduced by 1 by 15, that means the remaining part would be 14 by 15. Clear to you? Now second time, again you are removing 14.28%. Now what is 14.28%? It is 1 by 7 of the total solution. Now, if you are removing 1 by 7 of total, you will be left with 6 by 7 of the total now, right? This is the, after the first operation, this is the milk that you have left now. After the second operation, you will have 6 by 7 of this percentage of milk. That is a successive decrement will be applied. Now, third time, you are removing 8.33%. Removing 8.33% means you are removing 1 by 12 of the solution. Removing 1 by 12 of the solution means you will now be left with 11 by 12 of the solution. Clear? Now just solve it and you will get your answer. 7 into 2 is 14. 2 into 6, 12. 6 and 6 will get cancelled. So now you are left with 11 by 15 of 100% of milk. Now what is 11 by 15? This is what your answer will be. Just find out the percentage of 11 by 15. 1 by 15 is 6.67. Just multiply it with 11. And you will get your answer as 73.33%, right? That means percentage of milk left in the solution after 3 replacement would be 73.33%. Okay, have you done any mistake? It is not 16.67%. In the first operation, you are removing 6.67%. So 6.67 is 1 by 15. 16.67 is 1 by 6, Jadeep, that is right. But I am not removing 1 by 6, I am removing 6.67. So look at the question carefully. Is it clear to you? Right, so this complete chapter is dependent on two concepts. Right, as I told you earlier, I am saying it again and again. That which content out of the two solution, right? In a solution, if you have a mixture of two or three solution, which content will get reduced successively and by how much percentage it will get reduced, okay? Which fraction? In this case, because you are replacing it with water, so milk percentage will get reduced. So initially you have 100 liter of the milk, 100% of the milk. So first, in the first operation, it will get reduced by 6.67%. Reducing it by 6.67% means reducing it by 1 by 15. And in the second operation, you are reducing it by 14.28%. 14.28% means reducing it by 1 by 7. And in the third case, reducing it by 8.33%. That means reducing it by 1 by 12 fraction. Now you just need to know how to use this successive percentage decrement in terms of fraction, which we discussed in detail while we were discussing the concept of percentages. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Anyone having doubt, you can ask me in the comment section and then we can move on to the next question. Now you should know how to reduce it successively. That's it. Once you know how to reduce it successively, you will get your answer. Right? Two questions. Which, by how much percentage it will get reduced, or by how much fraction it will get reduced, and what, which part of the solution will get reduced, whether it will be milk or the water. Now if you are replacing it with water, that means water will percent, the water percentage will obviously will get up. If water percentage will go up, milk percentage will go down. So just start with the milk initial percentage and reduce it successively by the fractions that are mentioned in the questions. Now let's go to the next question. This is a bit advanced level question. Let's see how many of you can solve it. So I'm giving you 2 or 3 minutes to solve. Just attempt this question. From a 500 ml container, 50 ml is removed and 110 ml of water is added. Now in this case, you are removing 50 ml, but you are replacing it with 100 ml. Earlier, we were removing the same percentage and replacing it with the same percentage, right? So whatever part of the total solution you were removing, the same part of the total solution was added back. But here, 50 ml is removed and it is replaced with 100 ml of water. Again, 50 ml is removed from the resultant solution and the after the previous operation, and 100 ml of water is added. Third time again, 50 ml is removed from the present solution and 100 ml of water is added. What is the quantity of the milk in the solution now? What is the quantity of the milk in the solution now? So give me the answer. So what is the answer? You are just supposed to concentrate which out of milk and water, which content will get reduced. And if it is getting reduced successively, by how much fraction it will get reduced. And by what fraction it will get reduced, that depends what fraction of the total solution you are removing. That's it. So once you understand these two concepts, you can solve this question very easily. So in this case, you are removing 50 ml and replacing it with 100 ml of water. So can you tell me, out of milk and water, which will be getting reduced successively? Give me the answer of this question. In this case, you are removing 50 ml of this container and replacing it with 100 ml of water. I'm talking about the first operation. In the first operation, can you tell me, out of milk and water, which will get reduced successively? Just give me the answer of this question. Milk will get reduced, right? Now, Shrey, can you tell me by what fraction it will get reduced? The next question that you are supposed to answer is by what fraction it will get reduced? By what fraction it will get reduced? Can you answer this question? Yes, Jadeep, milk is the right answer, that milk will get reduced. But now tell me by what fraction it will get reduced. How will you get the fractional value by which it will get reduced successively? That depends not 10, by 1 by 10, right? By 1 by 10 is right, right? See, you are removing 50 out of 500. So 50 out of 500 is what fraction? It is 1 by 10. So you know how to reduce successively by 1 by 10, right? So initially, how much milk you have? 500. So after the first operation, how much of the milk you will be left with? It would be 9 by 10. And what is 9 by 10 of 500? 450. That means after the first operation, the milk left in the solution would be 450. Is it clear to you? After the first operation, it will be milk left would be 450. Now, once again, you are now again removing 50 ml. So once you add 100 ml back, now here the questions structure is getting changed, right? After you remove 50 ml, you are replacing it with 100 ml. Now, what is the meaning of it? When you add 100 ml, see, once you remove 50 ml, the total solution left would be 450. And when I add 100 ml of the water, total solution will become 550, right? Total solution will become 550. And out of this 550, what is milk? Milk is 450. And what is water? Water is 100. Now, can you tell me, when I remove 50 ml again, which content will get reduced? It will be milk again. But now the question is, by how much fraction it will get reduced? The moment you get to know about how much fraction of the milk will get reduced now, you will be able to solve this question. Now tell me, in the second operation, by what fraction it will get reduced? After the first operation, the milk in the solution is 450 ml, right? And you are adding 100 ml of water. 450 milk and 100 ml of water. So this is milk. So total solution now is 550 ml, right? So now you are removing 50 out of 550, right? So fraction of milk will now get reduced by how much fraction? Milk will get reduced by how much fraction? Not 100 by 11. Yeah, when you are talking about in terms of fraction, it should be 1 by 11. See, you are removing 50 ml of the solution out of 550. So 50 is what percentage of 550? It is 1 by 11. So if you remove 1 by 11, you will be left with 10 by 11. Is it clear to you? Now this is the milk left in the solution after the second operation. Clear? This is the milk left in the solution after the second operation. Now do not solve it at present, right? Because this value will go in fraction. Now when you removed 50 ml out of 550, what is the total solution that you will be left with? It would be 500, right? When you remove 50 ml from 550, the total solution now will be 500 ml. And when you add 100 ml of water back to the solution, total solution is now 600, right? Total solution is now 600. Now again you are removing 50 ml, right? Third time again you are removing 50 ml. Now you can you tell me, the milk percentage will get reduced by how much fraction in the third case? When I'm removing 50 ml of the total solution the third time, can you tell me by what fraction it will get reduced? After the second operation, the total solution is 600 ml, right? The total solution is 600 ml. And the milk is 10 by 11 of 450. Can you tell me, when I do this operation for the third time, by what fraction milk will get reduced? The moment you get to know the fraction it will get reduced, you will be able to solve this question. You are removing 50 ml. 50 ml from what part? 50 ml from 600. Now the total solution is 600. Please concentrate on the total solution. What fraction of the total solution you are removing? The moment you get to know about it, you will be able to get to know the fraction by which the milk percentage will get reduced successively. You are removing 50 ml out of 600 ml now. Now 50 out of 60 is what? 1 by 12. That means if you are removing 1 by 12 of the total solution, the milk will get reduced by 1 by 12. So the solution left, the milk left is 450 into 10 by 11 after the second operation. And after the third operation, it would be 11 by 12. Because in the third case, you will be removing 1 by 12 of the total. So 1 by 12 of the total means remaining would be 11 by 12. So 11 and 11 get cancelled. So now it would be 5 by 6. 450 into 5 by 6 is what? You just have to solve it. This would be 75. 75 into 5 is 375. That means after doing this operation for 3 times, the milk left in the solution would be 375. Yes, Karthikeyan, 375 is the right answer. Right? Some of you who haven't understood it right, till now, let me explain you again. See, initially you have 500 of the total milk solution, right? So initially you are removing 50 ml. So now 50 is what percentage of 500? It is 10%. That means it is 1 by 10 of total. So milk percentage after the first operation will get reduced by 10%. So you will be left with 90%. 90% means you will, after the first operation, milk left in the solution would be 450. Now, when you add 100 ml of the water back to the solution, total solution will now become 550. Now, out of 550, there is 450 milk, right? Now, you are again removing 50 out of 550. 50 out of 550 is 1 by 11. That means the milk left in the solution will get reduced by 1 by 11. So, it will be 10 by 11. The milk left in the solution will be 10 by 11 of 450. Clear? This would be after the second operation. But now you also need to concentrate what will be the total solution. So out of 550 ml, you're removing 50 ml. So total now left would be 500, and then you adding 100 ml of the solution. So total will now be 600. So the moment you start the third operation, you will be left with 600. And now if you're removing 50 out of 600, that means you are removing 1 by 12 of total. Removing 1 by 12 of total means you will now be left with 11 by 12 of the previous milk that is left, right? So 450 into 10 by 11 into 11 by 12, solve it and you'll get the answer as 375. So percentage of milk left in the solution after doing this operation is 375. And you can observe it, all these questions of removal and replacement are dependent on one single concept, that is a case of successive percentage decrement. Then the case of successive percentage decrement is what we have done in detail while discussing the concept of percentage as well as of profit and loss also, because a loss percentage, discount percentage also are a case of decrement, right? But then again we have discussed the case of successive decrement in the percentage also. Clear? So same concepts are used. Okay, it is just that you are supposed to link all these concepts. Once you are able to link this concept, you can get to know how these concepts will be used in these type of questions. Okay, so all removal and replacement questions are basically a case of successive decrement, nothing else. Clear to you? The only two things that you're supposed to know, by what fraction it will get reduced, that depends how much of the total solution you are removing, and which content will get reduced. Obviously, the content that you are not replacing will get reduced successively. That's it. The moment you get to know these two values, you will get to know the answer of all these questions. So now let's do this question. Can you give me the answer of this question now? From a 200 liter of milk, 20 liter of water is added. Now first you are adding here, and then 40 liter of the solution is removed. Okay, next 60 liter of the water is added and 80 liter of the solution is removed. Find the amount of the milk in the liters in the solution now. So you are doing the operation for twice, and you are adding 20 liter first and then removing 40 liter, and next you are adding 60 liter and then removing 80 liter. Now, can you give me the answer of this question? Yes, what will be the answer of this question? (1200/11) is the right answer. Very good. Observe this question carefully. Initially, you have a 200 milk, right? And you are adding 20 liter of water. So that means the total solution will now be 220, in which 200 will be milk and 20 will be water. Now, 40 liter of the solution is removed. See, you are replacing it. Now first you are adding and then replacing, and what you are adding is water. That means what content will get reduced? It will be the milk that will be reducing, right? So initially you have 200 of the milk. Now let's see in the first operation by how much fraction it will get reduced. In the first case, you are removing 40 liter of total. Now 40 is what fraction of 220? It is 2/11. So after the first operation, you will be left with 9/12, right? After the first operation, you will be left with a 9/12 of 200. And in the second case, when you add 60 liter of water, now you are adding 60. So once you removed 40 from 220, you will be left with 180 liter of total solution. But now you are adding 60 liter more. So total solution will now be 240. And out of 240, now you are removing how much? 80 liter. So just see. 80 is what fraction of 240? 80 is 1/3 of 240. So if it is 1/3 of 240, you will be left with 2/3 of it. 2/3 of the remaining milk now. Just solve it and you'll get your answers. Okay. So you see it is 200 into 6/11, which is 1200/11%. Now you can solve it by yourself. 1200/11 will be the milk left in the solution. Just solve it and you will get your answer. Clear to you? Right? Yes, 109.09 is the right answer. Okay? So now guys, let's move on to the next question. Now solve this question. This question was asked in previous year CAT paper. Not the exactly the same question. The values are changed. Right? So give me the answer. Now if you can solve this question, that means you have understood this concept. This is exactly on the pattern of the previous year CAT exam question asked recently in CAT exam, that 20 liters are drawn off from a vessel full of water and substituted by pure milk. Again, 12 liters of the mixture are drawn off and substituted by pure milk. So it is given that you are removing 12 liters of the solution, right? It is given that you are removing 12 liters of water and substituted by pure milk. Now, this word is very important, that you are replacing it with a pure milk. Again, same content of the solution, that is 12 liter of the solution, is removed and substituted by pure milk. So the replaced content is pure milk. That means milk percentage will go up. If milk percentage will go up, which will get reduced? It will be the other content, that is water. So our answer to the first question is that which content will get reduced is water. Water will get reduced. Now the next question is by how much fraction it will get reduced, but it is not given. The total solution is not given. Percentage of total solution is also not given. But it is given that if the vessel now contains water and milk in the ratio of 25:56, find the capacity of the vessel. Now use this information. How can you use this information? How can you connect it with the concept? Solve it and then we will discuss the solution. So guys, if you want to learn more questions of mixture and solution, I just want to inform to all of you that I have recorded a course of arithmetic without formulas, mixture and solution, which is available on Unacademy learning app. right? So if you're looking for some more practice questions, I have recorded around 18 questions on mixture and solutions, covering all different type of questions which are dependent on the concept of removal and displacement, right? So that course is available on my profile on Unacademy. You can visit my profile on Unacademy and you can watch this complete course, right? For the revision purpose as well as some, or for some more different type of practice question. Okay, we'll not probably be able to solve all the 18 questions in today's lesson. I guess six or seven questions we will be over by the time we'll discuss seven questions, time will be over for the session. So if you want to watch all lessons or questions from the topic of mixture and solution, visit my profile on Unacademy that I have shown to you at the start of the session. That is sameersardana.ubs5752. And or just search my name in the educator list and you will get all the courses recorded by me on Unacademy Learning app. There you will find this complete course of mixture and solution, that is arithmetic without formulas, part 3, mixture and solution. Okay, so all 18 questions of this particular topic are recorded there. So you can access all those lessons. Come on guys, what will be the answer of this question? Exactly the same question of previous year CAT paper. See guys, again, just answer two questions. Which content will get reduced in this case? You are replacing it by pure milk, so it will get replaced with water, right? The water will get reduced successively. The first answer of first question is water. That in this case, water will get reduced successively. Now by how much fraction it will get reduced, the total fraction, the content that you're removing is what fraction of the total will tell you the percentage of water by which it will get reduced. Now the problem with the question is we have not been provided with any information what is the total solution. Now let's assume the total solution, that means let's say the total capacity of this vessel. Now this is a vessel which is full of water, right? Now let's say this is X liter water. So now when I removed 12 liter out of it, that means what fraction of the total I am removing? I am removing 12 by X of total. That means my water percentage will get reduced by the fraction of 12 by X, right? And if then again it is substituted by pure milk, so again you are removing 12 liter, so the second time again your water percentage will get reduced successively by 12 by x, right? So you are doing it for the two times and both of the time your water percentage is getting reduced successively by 12 by x. The moment you get to know about this, you will get your answers. So assuming that the total solution is x initially and you are removing 12 by x part of it, that means it will get reduced by 12 by x. So after the first operation, in the water left in the solution would be x into 1 minus 12 by x, right? Hope you know about this basic successive percentage decrement. If I have to reduce a value by 1 by 3, I will take 2 by 3 part of it. And how would I get to know why would I be taking 2 by 3? Because 1 minus 1 by 3 is 2 by 3, right? So similarly, if I'm removing 12 by x of total, if I want to decrease something by 12 by x, I will be left with 1 minus 12 by x of total. So initially you have x liter of water. After the first operation, you will be left with 1 minus 12 by x. And after the second operation, this will get reduced successively again by 1 minus 12 by x. Okay. So this is the quantity of water left in the solution now. This is quantity of water left in the solution now. That is x into 1 minus 12 upon x square. Right. X into 1 minus 12 upon x square is the quantity of the water left in the solution now. And also it is given that after doing this operation twice, you are left with the water and milk percent ratio is 25:56. Now, what is the meaning of this? The water and milk percentage is given as 25:56. That means out of the total 81, the milk left now is 25. So if our total is x, the milk now left would be 25 upon 81 of x. So just equate it with the equation that 25 upon 81x, right? 25 upon 81x is the total water left in the solution, and that will be equal to x into 1 minus 12 upon x into 1 minus 12 upon x. That is x into 1 minus 12 upon x square, whole square, will be equal to 25 upon 81x. So x and x will get cancelled. So 1 minus 12 upon x will be square root of 25 by 81, that is 5 by 9. So 12 upon x will be equal to 1 minus 5 by 9. Solve it, you will get the value of x as 27. So that means initially the capacity of the vessel is 27, or you can say initially you started with 27 liter of the milk, 27 liter of the water, because the container was full. That means the capacity of the vessel is also 27 liter. Is it clear to all of you? Just remember, try to answer two questions. That's it. By what fraction the content will get reduced and which fraction will get reduced? These two questions will give you the answer of each and every question, guys. Clear? Yes, Ashish, you're saying that I have to go for dinner at 8 a.m. to about 9 a.m. So you can watch the recording, Ashish. If there's a problem with the timing, you can watch the recording that is available on YouTube. Also, you can access my lessons on Unacademy learning app, right? Same lessons are available there also. Okay. So I will try to change the time if it is comfortable so that you can attend the session. So guys, I'm ending the session here. We have discussed only 6 questions. There are some more questions also, but again, now the time is about to be over. So you can access all of the lessons of mixture and solution available on Unacademy learning app, right? There you will find all 18 questions of mixture and solution. All different type of questions are covered there. So guys, thank you so much for attending the session. Good night. Hope you have understood this complete concept in detail. Revise the session carefully. This is a very, very important concept, because every year you will definitely have one question from mixture and solution. Now this is just one part, right, of mixture and solution, that is removal and replacement based questions. All right, guys, thank you so much for attending the session. Good night. See you then tomorrow at the same time with the next topic of ratio and proportion. So this is my profile on Unacademy, where you can access all these courses. Okay, so you can revise those courses there also. Yes, Jadeep, thank you. Welcome all of you. Good night.